Hello, my name is Michael O'Keefe, a.k.a. The Movie Wisdom. If you enjoy this interview and want to hear more top-notch film industry conversations, please press the thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and hit the bell to stay in the know. London Brown, do you enjoy coming to Toronto?
Man, it's always an exciting time to come out here in general, but especially, you know, for Tiff to catch the films, see old friends. But the Canadians here, you guys are nice. I appreciate that, man. Just good energy. So it's always fun coming here.
Good energy. People are nice. Okay, got it. So tell me about the show Ballers. For people who haven't seen it, what's it about?
The show Ballers basically just gives you an inside look at how football is, American football, NFL, how it operates in the offseason. We deal with everything from relationships, bad investment deals, love, pain addiction, pain med addictions. We cover into some politics as well, but it's also a great insight on the fast cars, the women, the party scene as well. We got a little something for everybody to enjoy.
That's fun, and you know, with Kaepernick and everything, the NFL is like, you know, really right. Political these days.
Exactly, and so Ballers always has a way of just touching on the subjects because the show is almost like shot in real time. In fact, our show airs. The season airs in the off season as it would the NFL.
Oh,
so when
cool.
The season ends, it's just like the NFL picking back up. So they line it up like that. It's really clever how they do it.
That is clever scheduling. So Dwayne Johnson seems like a total sweetheart. You know his persona. Tell me the real life guy.
Yes.
So what's he like?
Dwayne Johnson, really nice guy, dude.
Yeah.
He's you know. He's whatever you think he is. Like, you feel his presence when he walks into a room. Like, he is that guy. But he always is really good to his fans. And as far as working with him, it was a pleasure to work with him because he didn't have an ego.
Really?
But if he wanted to, he could, because he's the highest paid actor in the world right now and everything.
Yeah.
But he has a really cool attitude. And I think that helped to create the temperature of energy on set. Everyone's cool, no egos at all. We really were, you know, the friends.
That's dope. And I read you're also a stand-up comedian.
Yes.
So,
yeah.
Besides yourself, who's the best in the game?
Chappelle right now. Chappelle right now.
Six and Sums?
Say it again? Oh, yeah. Oh. You know what it is? What's wild is that, because it's mixed reviews on it.
Yeah.
But what I could appreciate, even if you don't agree with what he said or even like the content, if you didn't laugh at all, the work ethic that it takes to put an hour special is serious, and he's already I think dropped maybe three or I think like four
There's
within the past
five.
Like five yeah. within the past couple years
yeah.
I'm like that's an incredible work ethic. That alone puts him in his own box.
Yeah he's really gotten better. I would say
I think so too.
Stand up since like the early
2000s. Right
how he looks at race and class and like,
all of that
sexuality,
man.
Like it's really evolved. It's really deep stuff.
I think so.
Yeah.
He has a nice way of just putting it all together like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so I think that's to be commended.
All right. Yeah, yeah. Dope. So for those who've never put, like, because there's people who can tell jokes, there's people who can tell stories.
Yeah.
You're talking about how it's credible that he has a set like of that. Like, how do you organize jokes and stories into a set?
Usually we work them out in like 5 to 10 minute sets, and we flush the jokes out until they get what we call until the jokes get some legs. We come up with some premises. Sometimes we work out on stage where we may have ideas or things we thought about throughout the day. We go on through, go right on stage. You tell them. We go back and listen to our sets, stuff like that, and we start to build that hour up very slowly.
Mm.
But it's definitely a process. For sure.
It sounds intense. And it's always like amazing how they go from one thing to another.
Yeah.
Seamlessly, but you know that timing and that rhythm.
All
so
of that.
Hours or day, you know, a long,
absolutely.
Long time.
So when people see Chappelle,
yeah.
Sometimes he'll just be in the club and or even when he does a special, it just seems like he's just talking. But those jokes are very well crafted.
Yeah.
You know, but the relaxed demeanor is also a skill to be able to just be really easy going, very conversational. He's found his voice for sure.
I agree with you 100%. So tell me about your movie Real Talk, because this is a radio show and that's a movie about radio, right?
Well, Real Talk, I think where it comes across with it just being able to touch on a lot of different things, and it dives into these interesting dynamics of relationships, and not just like intimate relationships, but just relationship between within people. And so for me, I always try to keep myself in the mix of projects that continue to push me and to stretch me a little bit.
Yeah, that's good.
So I dig it, man.
You gotta have the unexpected, that element of danger a little bit, right?
All of that. That's the thing also with stand-up. Stand-up, yeah. We don't really know if the audience is gonna laugh. So it's like a small gamble every time you get on stage. So hopefully if you're good, you continue to win.
Are you a Radiohead? Did you have some radio personalities or shows that you like?
There's a couple. There's a comedian by the name of Earthquake. And when I listen to radio sometimes, I just wanna, like, I like being able to listen to radio, and like back in the day, like they would paint the picture so well with the words. Or if they're really engaging, I found myself arguing with the radio because I wish I could call in. So yeah. I could dig a little bit.
Yeah, I love Shade 45, for example.
Okay, yeah.
There's a great host.
I did do Shade 45.
Oh, yeah. You were on Shade 45?
Yeah, I think I did Shade 45 a year ago. So yeah, they are good. I forgot about them. They're good, absolutely.
Yeah. And then Charlemagne the God's killing it right now.
Charlemagne, absolutely. Yeah. Charlemagne, Sway in the Morning.
Sway in the Morning is classic.
Yeah, you're naming some ones, man. I forgot about those. You name them.
Hot 97 as well. New York radio really kills it.
Yeah.
I think. I'm not as familiar with Los Angeles radio.
Right.
Personally, I'm sure, you know, LA is great though for many, many things.
Yeah.
So, having grown up in LA, did you always want to act? Was that like always in the DNA?
Being an artist was. I figured out acting later on, but at first, you know, anything that involved the arts, I was doing it.
Yeah.
So, but the acting came when I was maybe in my teens or early teens. But it was actually, let me put it this way, I've always enjoyed doing it. I didn't decide to really take it seriously until early teens, where I started taking theater classes and touring during theater. And then, of course, years later, I ended up booking my first TV show called The Hustle on Fuse. That was my first time here in Toronto because I had to do like red carpet work for the MMAs.
Oh, cool.
MMAs? I think it's
MBAs?
Yeah, I think it's MBAs. The incredible war show that you guys have here.
MMVAs, the Much Music Video.
There you go. That's one. That's it.
Absolutely. All right. So, you're talking about all, you're a Renaissance man.
I've been told that.
Yeah. So, if you had to, like, to say, like, I can only do one of these things,
it would probably be stand-up, because I don't have to audition for it. It's like, whenever I want to do it, just give me a mic and a room of people, and, you know, we can do it. But acting is right next to it. It's a brother. They're siblings, I would say.
They're siblings.
Yeah.
Well, London Brown, thank you very much for your time. Is there any other projects you'd like to push before I let you go?
Yeah, there's a project I did called Brownsville, directed by Lawrence Fishburne and starring Lorenz Tate and a couple other people.
Okay.
And it's an audio series, speaking of this whole audio thing and radio.
Yeah.
That's an audio series that people can check out. I believe like spring of next year, called Bronzeville. So it should be really good. I play a ruthless gangster on there, and it's been doing well. It's been doing well.
Bronzeville has many great MCs. MOP, Sean Price.
Boom.
Got him. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.